Huntington, West Virginia. Home for the Chesapeake and Ohio's Huntington shops, where many steam and diesel locomotives were looked over and repaired. Even into the days of CSX, hundreds of diesels get checked over every year, restored for donation, or rebuilt with new technology, while most sit outside and decay. But if you were to look real close at the locomotive sitting outside, you'll probably encounter one that's not like the others. This is none other than one of the many obscure oddities on CSX, and she was known as HLS1. Spin Master Moogie. EMD SC45 was first introduced in 1965 to mark the debut of the rather iconic 645 Prime Movers. While sales for the locomotive were outstanding, the SC45 suffered from engine failures due to her troubled Prime Mover, and railroads opted instead to purchase the more reliable SC40s. It wasn't until 1972 when EMD started introducing the -2 series, which were an update to the existing locomotives on their catalog, but with newer electronics for more efficiency. EMD would roll out the newer SC45-2 in 1972, with 136 units produced in total. Compared to the original SC45, they sold less of the -2, thanks in part to the SC40-2 being more successful in sales. Only four railroads would end up purchasing these locomotives, with one of them, the Clinchfield Railroad, taking on 18 units. And this is where our unit comes in. Clinchfield number 3611 was built in November 1972 as one of the 18 units bought by the railroad. Its life was rather uneventful as it was often used for marshaling heavy coal trains through the Appalachians alongside her sisters. Fast forward to 1983, when the Clinchfield Railroad would be dragged into family lines to make the Seaboard system. 3611, while receiving the Seaboard patching, would still retain its original Clinchfield number and livery well into the early 80s. However, not long after though, the SC45-2s were renumbered from the 3600s to the 8900s, with 3611 being renumbered to 8969. But keeping its Clinchfield logo as the unit never received the Seaboard system colors in service. 3 years after the merger, the Seaboard system would merge with Chessie system to create Chessie Seaboard X. Express? CSX. For 8969, it kept its number intact, only a CSX patch job as a major change. Unfortunately, not much info is known on its CSX career, other than it was likely retired around the mid-1990s alongside her sisters. While many of them were sold to leasing companies, stored, or likely scrapped, 8969 would eventually be retired and would be put into storage for an uncertain future. Around the 90s, CSX was looking for a new load test unit for their locomotives at their Huntington shops, and by chance, chose 8969 to be that unit. Before I continue on, I'll clarify what a load test unit is. A load test unit is a modified locomotive used to test the electric generator on a locomotive. The load test unit is usually running the paired locomotive at notch 8, and letting the paired unit do all the work to see how it performs. This can be from fresh mainline units to rebuilt ones. CSX already had two load test units at their Waycross shops, in the forms of U36B number 7764 and B36-7 number 5829, with the former being preserved as of today. Anyways, back on 8969. 8969 would be repainted into a unique variant of the Y&2 livery, with the words Huntington Load Test painted on the side and front. It also sported a one-off variant of the CSX logo, with the phrase, "We're up to the test," underneath, and gaining a new number in the form of HLS1, with the HLS standing for Huntington Locomotive Shops. From that point on, HLS1 would be responsible for testing various CSX locomotives on a small string of track outside the shops. She would be paired up with various locomotives old and new during her use, and the purpose is what kept her around today. Presumably. Recent photos, the very few at least, suggest that HLS1 had been sitting around Huntington for many years, and likely doesn't serve its purpose that often, seeing as Huntington seems to be a place more of storage for locomotives compared to a rebuilding place, but that could be me. However, recent images show that HLS1 still is on CSX property, clearly present, but whether she still does load test is unknown. In conclusion, HLS1 is a rather distinct locomotive on CSX for how it went from an ordinary life to serving a different purpose for the company. It goes to show that a regular workhorse can get repurposed to a rather unique purpose not many locomotives get assigned to. In my opinion, I do hope that HLS1 does get preserved in a distant future, as it's one of the former Clinchfield SE-45 still around in the 21st century. Its significance and assignment managed to make it stand out amongst other CSX locomotives of the time, and it's these reasons that HLS1 should be known as Huntington's hidden gem. Thank you.